Let me show you how to protect a DASH VOD content using AWS Elemental MediaConvert with PallyCon Multi-DRM. If you want to follow this hands-on video, you need to prepare these items as you can see in this slide. First, you need an account on PallyCon service side. You can start a free trial on PallyCon.com. After signing up, please find the below information on our web console and online document. You also need an AWS account and basic knowledge of AWS services such as IAM, S3, and AWS Media Services. Please create a media convert role in IAM and S3 buckets for input and output storage, and upload a source video to storage. Let's create a job in AWS and Elemental Media Convert service. In the AWS Management Console, select the Media Convert service. You can see the job list I tried before. Click Create Job button to create a new job and start the configuration. In the job setting page, you need to set the Media Convert role that you already created in IAM. Then go to the input page to set the input video file stored in S3. You can browse your S3 storage and find the uploaded video. Click the Add button next to the output groups. I create a DASH output group with PlayReady and Widebind DRM encryption. If you want to create an HRS output with FairPlay DRM, you can create a separate output group similarly. In the DASH output group, you can type any custom group name you want, and you may set the output destination to your S3 bucket. Then let's enable DRM encryption, which is the most important part of this hands-on video. You need to input the resource ID that should be the same value as the content ID of PallyCon DRM integration. This resource ID value will be used in the DRM license request to identify the content and get the encryption key used for the content. And you need to input the DRM system ID here. Let's enter the system ID for PlayReady and Widebind to support the two DRMs in a single DASH output. Next, let's input the KMS URL with the API token into the key provider URL field. If you have an account on PallyCon service, you can find your API token on PallyCon web console. And that is all for the DRM encryption setting. Now, let's set up the outputs in the output group. As a requirement for Widebind DRM, we need to separate the audio and video outputs. So I'll name the default output as video output and add another output named audio output. Then let's click the output one and remove the audio track from it. Similarly, we need to remove the video track from the output two. It is up to you to set any encoding options to the audio and video outputs, but you need to make sure if your target client supports the codec and other encoding options. I'll use the default settings that use the ABC and AAC codecs for the best device coverage. Now we have two separate outputs for video and audio. Let's click the Create button at the right bottom to start the job. After the media convert job is done, we can go to the S3 storage to check the output files. You need to make the output folder public so that the client player can access the DASH content. In a real-world service scenario, you may want to use CDN to deliver the packaged stream to end users. But I'll just stream from the S3 directly to simplify this demonstration. Now let's try playing the packaged DASH output with an HTML5 player. Since the output is encrypted by DRM, you cannot play it without proper DRM license integration. PallyCon Multi-DRM supports token-based and callback-based license integration types. We recommend the token type because it is better for large-scale global license requests. Also, in a real-world service scenario, you need to implement the license token generation logic on your content service backend. We provide the integration guide and samples to help our customers to do it. But in this demonstration, I'll create a test token using our Dev Console website. It is a fast way to test the playback of DRM encrypted content without any server-side development. To create a token, you need to input some parameters such as the site ID, site key, and access key, and the content ID, which is the same as the resource ID in the media convert setting. In the token role field, you can input a JSON string that specifies various license policies to manage the playback and security of the content. I'll just use the default policy to make it simple. And I'll leave the timestamp empty to set the current time automatically. When you click the Request Token button, you will see the license token data as a result. Let's copy the token and go to the test player page on the Dev Console. For the DASH URL, you can get the object URL of the MPD file on the AWS console. And you need to input the license token data to the PallyCon custom data field. Click the play button and you can see that the DRM protected DASH content plays well. If you try to play the DASH URL without the license token or with an invalid token, you will see an error message instead. That is the end of the hands-on video. Please feel free to contact us on our website if you have any questions.